Let's begin with a review of the information model for an Oracle Financials Cloud General Ledger application and how it's mapped to the information model in Enterprise Data Management Cloud. In Financials Cloud General Ledger, the chart of accounts consists of segments. Examples of segments are department, account, product, and so on. We'll use an account segment in our example. Each segment has a value set that provides the set of values for that segment, along with the formatting and validation for those values. Value sets are organized in hierarchies using trees that can have one or more versions. When you register a Financials Cloud General Ledger application in Enterprise Data Management Cloud, the wizard creates an application and default view to represent the external application. For each segment and value set, the wizard creates a dimension, a default viewpoint, a list type node set, and a node type. For each tree and its version, the wizard creates a viewpoint, a hierarchy type node set, and a hierarchy set. The hierarchy sets use the node type for both parent and child nodes. These data chain objects not only manage the data for you, but also apply business validation rules to the data. I'm logged in as a user with the application creator role. Select Applications and click Register. Select Financials Cloud General Ledger as the application type. Enter an application name and optional description and click Next. Here, you can define the connection to your Financials Cloud General Ledger application. You can complete this step separately from the registration process, so I'll skip this step for now. Click Create. In Active Languages, enter the languages that have an active status in the Financials Cloud General Ledger application. Select a single base language for the application. You can choose from any of the languages that you added as active languages in the previous step. Optionally, you can set preferences that apply to your application. Select Allow Multiple Active Tree Versions to allow the start and end dates of multiple versions of a tree to overlap. Select Allow Multiple Root Nodes to enable more than one root node in a tree. Select Allow Duplicate Nodes to enable shared nodes in a tree. Let's keep all options selected. In Max Depth, enter the depth limit for the data in your tree structure, or enter -1 if your tree structure does not have a depth limit. Click Next. Descriptive flex fields are user-defined fields that let you capture additional attributes about segment values. For example, a product segment could contain descriptive flex fields for color or size. There are two types of descriptive flex fields. Global descriptive flex fields are applied to all segments in an application. Context-sensitive descriptive flex fields are applied only to specific segments. Let's add a global descriptive flex field. Enter the flex field name and specify whether or not it's required. The column field determines the location of the value for this flex field in import and export files. When you select an attribute location, that location is no longer available to be selected for another flex field. For the flex field property, you can create a new property or select an existing property. For this example, I'll select Add New Property and click Next. By default, the new property name is DFF Flexfield Name. Optionally, you can change the name and enter a description for the property. Click Next to specify the parameters for the property, including case, length, and allowed values. I'll accept the defaults and click Next to return to the Global Descriptive Flexfields page. Note, the names and properties of global descriptive flex fields must be unique and cannot be reused in either another global or context-sensitive flex field. At this point, you can add another global descriptive flex field or click Next to continue the registration. On this page, you add segments. For segment information, enter the value set code for the segment and, optionally, a description. Select Natural Account Segment if this segment is used as the natural account in a chart of accounts. Specify if the values in the value set are text or numeric. And enter the maximum character length for the values in the value set. Click Next to continue to the value type definition. Here, you can define a minimum and maximum value for the values in the value set. For text value type only, you can select uppercase if the value set values must contain only capital letters. Select zero fill to specify that the value must have as many characters as the maximum character length. I'll keep all fields set to their default values and click Next. Context-sensitive descriptive flex fields are applied only to specific segments, and both the flex field name and its associated property can be reused in other segments. Let's add a flex field to this segment. The setup is similar to creating a global descriptive flex field. You enter a name, specify if the flex field is required, select the location for the attribute in import and export files, and either create a new property or select an existing one. You can change the name or enter a description for the property and specify the parameters for the property. At this point, you can add another flex field to the segment or click Next to continue the registration. Now you add trees to the segment. Enter the tree code, the tree version name, and the start and end date for the version. Click Next to return to the list of trees for the segment. You can add more trees to the segment, or click Next to return to the list of segments. Here, you can add more segments, or click Next to continue the registration. In this step, you create and manage financial categories. The default list includes 49 predefined financial categories. You can add a category to the list, modify a category, or remove a category. When you're done with financial categories, click Next. Review the registration summary. Click Apply to finalize the registration. A confirmation is displayed that the data chain objects were created successfully, and the registered application is now available on the Applications page. You can now perform imports and exports, run extracts, modify the registration, and so on. Let's look at the data chain objects created for the application. A default view for the application was created with default viewpoints. The application was registered with one segment, corporate account, and one tree, all corporate accounts, that has one version, V1. Therefore, the registration process created two viewpoints, a list viewpoint called corporate account, and a hierarchy viewpoint called all corporate accounts V1. Let's inspect the corporate account viewpoint. The viewpoint is associated with the corporate account dimension and the corporate account node set, which were both generated during the registration process. The corporate account viewpoint was created to manage the list of segment values for a value set. When you inspect the node set, you see that its structure is defined as list. Now let's inspect the all corporate accounts V1 viewpoint. This viewpoint is associated with the corporate account dimension, the All Corporate Accounts V1 node set, and the All Corporate Accounts V1 hierarchy set. The All Corporate Accounts V1 viewpoint was created to manage a tree and tree version. When you inspect the node set, you see that its structure is defined as hierarchy. When I add nodes to a viewpoint, the defined maximum character length is enforced, and property fields for both the global and context-sensitive descriptive flex fields that I defined during registration are included as required fields. To learn more, visit docs.oracle.com.